later, for the priest is ready.
I fly, Biondello, but they may chance to need thee at home, therefore leave us.
Leave us, Biondello.
Nay, faith, I'll see the church of your back, and then come back to my master as soon as I can.
I marvel Cambio comes not all this while.
Sir, here's the door. This is Lucentio's house. My father's bears more toward the marketplace. Thither must I, and here I leave you, sir.
You shall not choose but drink before you go. I think I shall command your welcome here. And by all likelihood, some cherries to all.
They're busy within. You were best knock louder.
Well, once he that knocks as he would beat down the gate.
Is Signor Lucentio within, sir?
He's within, sir, but not to be spoken withal.
What if a man bring him £100 or two to make merry withal?
Keep your £100 to yourself. He shall need none so long as I live.
Nay, I told you your son was well-beloved in Padua. Do you hear, sir? To leave frivolous circumstances, I pray you tell Signor Lucentio that his father has come from Pisa and is here at the door to speak with him.
Thou liest! His father has come from Padua and here, looking out at the window.
Art thou his father?
Aye, sir. So his mother says, if I may believe her.
Why, how now, gentlemen? Why, this is flat knavery to take upon you another man's name.
Lay hands on the villain. I believe her means to cousin somebody in this city under my countenance.
I'll see them in the church together. God send them good shipping. But who is here? My old master Vincentio. Now we are undone and brought to nothing.
Come hither, crack hemp.
I hope I may choose, sir.
Come hither, you rogue. What, have you forgot me?
Forgot you? No, sir. No, I could not forget you, for I never saw you before in all my life.
What, you notorious villain, didst thou never see thy master's father, Vincentio?
What, my old worshipful old master? Yes, marry, sir, see when he looks out of the window.
Is so indeed!
Oh, help! Help! Help!
Help!
Help!
Help! Help! Help!
Help!
Help! Senior Baptist!
Prithee, Caleb, stand aside and see the end of this controversy.
Sir, what are you that... What are you that offer to beat my servant?
What am I, sir? Nay, what are you, sir? Oh, immortal God, so fine villain! A silken doublet, a velvet hose, a scarlet cloak, and a copperin hat! Oh, I am undone, I am undone! While I play the good husband at home, my son and my servant spend all of the university!
How now? What's the matter?
What is the mad lunatic?
Sir, you seem a sober ancient gentleman by your habit, but your words show you were a madman. Why, sir, what sign did you if I wear pearl and gold? I thank my good father I am able to maintain it.
Thy father, oh villain, he is a sailmaker in Bergamo!
Oh, he mistakes, sir, he mistakes, sir. Pray, what do you think's his name?
His name, as if I knew not his name. I have brought him up ever since he was 3 years old, and his name is Tranio.
Away, away! Way mad ass, his name is Lucentio, and he is mine only son and heir to the lands of me, Signor Vincentio.
Lucentio! Oh, he hath murdered his master! Lay hold on him, I charge you in the Duke's name! Oh, my son, my son! Tell me, thou villain, where is my son, Lucentio?
Call forth an officer! Tell me this man's name to the jail! The Father Baptista! I told you, see, that he be forthcoming!
Carry me to the jail!
Stop, officer!
He shall not go to
prison! Talk not, Senor Gremio! I say he shall go to prison!
Take heed, Signor Baptista, lest you be coney catched in this business. I dare swear this is the right, Vincentio!
Swear if thou darest!
Nay, I dare not swear it.
Then thou wilt best say that I am not Lucentio!
Yes, I know thee to be Signor Lucentio.
Away with the doctor to the jail with him!
What praises may be hailed and abused! Oh, monstrous villain!
Oh, we are spoiled, and yonder he is. Master, deny him, forswear him, or else we are all undone.
Hold! Hold!
Pardon, sweet father.
Lives my sweetest son?
Pardon, dear father.
How's thou offended? Where is Lucentio?
Here's Lucentio, right son to the right Vincentio, that have by marriage made thy daughter mine, while counterfeit supposes bleared thine eye.
Here's packing with a witness to deceive us all.
Where is that damned villain Tranio that faced and braved me in this matter so?
Why, tell me, is not this my Cambio?
Cambio is changed into Lucentio.
Love wrought these miracles. Bianca's love made me exchange my state with Tranio, while he did bear my countenance in the town. And happily I have arrived at last unto the wished haven of my bliss. What Tranio did, myself enforced him to. Then pardon him, sweet father, for my sake.
I'll slit the villain's nose that would have sent me to the jail.
Do you hear, sir? Have you married my daughter without asking my goodwill?
Fear not, Baptista, we will content you, go to. But I will in to be revenged for this villainy.
I discern the depth of this knavery.
Look not pale, Bianca, thy father will not frown.
My cake is dough, but I'll in among the rest, out of hope of all,
but my share of the feast.
Husband, let's follow to see the end of this ado.
First kiss me, Kate, and we will.
What, in the midst of the street?
What, art thou ashamed of me?
No, sir, God forbid, but ashamed to kiss.
Why, then let's home again. Oh. Come, sir, let's away.
Nay, I will give thee a kiss. Now, pray thee, love, stay.
Is not this well? Come, my sweet Kate. Better once than never, for never too late.
At last, though long, our jarring notes agree. And time it is when raging war is done to smile at scapes and perils overblown. My fair Bianca, bid my father welcome, while I with selfsame kindness welcome thine. Brother Petruchio, sister Katharina, and thou, Hortensio, with thy loving widow. Feast with the best and welcome to my house. My banquet is to close our stomachs up after our great good cheer. Pray you sit down, for now we sit to chat as well as eat.
Nothing but sit and sit and eat and eat.
Padua affords this kindness, son Petruchio.
Padua affords nothing but what is kind.
For both our sakes, I would that word were true.
Now for my life, Hortensio fears his widow.
Then never trust me if I be a fear.
You are very sensible, and yet you miss my sense. I mean Hortensio is afeard of you.
He that is giddy thinks the world turns round.
Roundly replied.
Mistress, how mean you that?
Thus I conceive by him.
Conceives by me? How likes Hortensio that?
My widow says thus she conceives her tale.
Very well mended. Kiss him for that, good widow.
He that is giddy thinks the world turns round. I pray you tell me what you meant by that.
Your husband, being troubled with a shrew, measures my husband's sorrow by his woe. And now you know my meaning.
A very mean meaning.
Right, I mean you.
And I am mean indeed, respecting you.
To her, Kate, to her. 100 marks, my Kate doth put her down.
That's my office.
But like an officer. Have duty, lad.
I like Grimio, these quick-witted folks.
Believe me, sir, they butt together well.
Head and butt a hasty-witted body would say your head and butt were head and horn.
Aye, Miss Wardride, hath that awakened you?
Aye, but not frightened me. Therefore I'll sleep again.
Nay, that you shall not, since you had begun. Have it you for a better jest or two.
Am I your bird? I mean to shift my bush.
Oh,
and then pursue me as you draw your bow. You are welcome all.
She hath prevented me. Here, Signor Tranio, this bird you aimed at, though you hit her not. Therefore a health to all that shot and missed.
Oh, sir. Lucentio slipped me like his greyhound, which runs himself and catches for his master.
A good, swift simile, but something currish.
It is well, sir, that you hunted for yourself. Tis thought your deer does hold you at a bay.
Oh, Petruchio, Tranio hits you now.
I thank thee for that gird, good Tranio.
Confess, hath he not hit you here?
Has a little galled me, I confess. And as the jest did glance away from me, tis 10 to 1 it maimed you two outright.
Oh, in good sadness, son Petruchio, I think thou hast the very shrew of all.
Well, I say no.
Oh?
And therefore, for assurance, let each one send unto his wife. And he whose wife is most obedient to come at first when he doth send for her shall win the wager which we will propose.
Tent, what's the wager?
20 crowns.
20 crowns? I'll venture so much of my hawk or hound, but 20 times so much upon my wife.
100 then.
Content.
A match, 'tis done.
Oh. Who shall begin?
That will I. Go, Biondello. Bid your mistress come to me.
I'll go.
Son, I'll be your half, Bianca comes.
I'll have no halves, I'll bear it all myself. How now? What news?
Sir, my mistress sends you word that she is busy and she cannot come.
Oh, she is busy and she cannot come. Is that an answer?
Aye, and a kind one, too. Pray God, sir, your wife send you not a word.
I hope better.
Sir Biondello, go and entreat my wife to come to me forthwith.
Oh, entreat her? Nay, then she must needs come.
I'm afraid, sir, do what you can. Yours will not be entreated. Now, where's my wife?
She says you have some goodly jest in hand. She will not come. She bids you come to her.
Worse and worse. She will not come. Oh, vile, intolerable, not to be endured. Sir Grimio, go to your mistress. Say I command her come to me.
Oh, I know her answer.
What?
She will not.
The fouler fortune mine, and there an end.
Now, by my holiday, here comes Katharina.
What is your will, sir, that you send for me?
Where is your sister and Hortensio's wife?
They sit conferring by the parlor fire.
Go, fetch them hither. If they deny to come, swinge me them soundly forth unto their husbands. Away, I say, and bring them hither straight.
Here is a wonder, if you talk of a wonder.
And so it is. I wonder what it bodes.
Marry, Peace it bodes, and love, and quiet life. An awful rule and right supremacy. And to be short, what not that's sweet and happy?
Now, fair before thee, good Petruchio, the wager thou hast won. And I will add unto their losses 20,000 crowns, another dowry to another daughter, for she is changed as she had never been.
Nay, I will win my wager better yet, and show more sign of her obedience, her new-built virtue and obedience. See where she comes, and brings your froward wives as prisoners to her womanly persuasion. Catherine, that cap of yours becomes you not. Off with that bauble, throw it underfoot.
Oh, let me never have a cause to sigh till I be brought to such a silly pass.
Fie, what a foolish duty call you this.
I would your duty were as foolish too. The wisdom of your duty, fair Bianca, hath cost me 100 crowns since supper time.
The more fool you for laying on my duty.
Catherine, I charge thee, tell these headstrong women what duty they do owe their lords and husbands.
Oh, come, you are mocking. We will have no telling.
Come on, I say, and first begin with her.
She shall not.
I say she shall. And first begin with her.
Oh,
fie, fie. Unknit that threatening, unkind brow, and dart not scornful glances from those eyes to wound thy lord, thy king, thy governor. It blots thy beauty as frosts do bite the meads, confounds thy fame as whirlwinds shake fair buds, and in no sense is meet or amiable. A woman moved is like a fountain troubled, muddy, ill-seeming, thick, bereft of beauty. And while it is so, none so dry or thirsty will deign to sip or touch one drop of it. But thy husband is thy lord, thy life, thy keeper, thy head, thy sovereign. One that cares for thee and for thy maintenance, commits his body to painful labor both by sea and land, to watch the night in storms, the day in cold, whilst thou liest warm at home, secure and safe, and craves no other tribute at thy hands but love, fair looks, and true obedience, too little payment for so great a debt. Such duty as the subject owes the prince, even such a woman oweth to her husband, and when she's froward, peevish, sullen, sour, and not obedient to his honest will, what is she but a foul contending rebel and graceless traitor to her loving lord? I am ashamed that women are so simple, to offer war where they should kneel for peace, or seek for rule, supremacy, and sway when they are bound to serve, love, and obey. Why are our bodies soft and weak and smooth, unapt to toil and trouble in the world, but that our soft conditions and our hearts should well agree with our external parts? Come, come, you froward and unable worms. My mind hath been as big as one of yours, my heart as great, my reason haply more, to bandy word for word and frown for frown. But now I see our lances are but straws. Our strength as weak, our weakness past compare, that seeming to be most, which we indeed least are. Then veil your stomachs, for it is no boot, and place your hands below your husband's foot, in token of which duty, if he please. My hand is ready. May it do him ease.
Why, there's the wench. Come on and kiss me, Kate.
Well, go thy ways, old lad, for thou shalt had.
'Tis a good hearing when children are to ward.
But a harsh hearing when women are froward.
Come, Kate, we'll to bed. We three are married, but you two are sped. 'Twas I won the wager, though you hit the white. And being a winner, God give you good night.
Now go thy ways, thou hast tamed a curse true.
'Tis a wonder, by your leave, she will be tamed so.